Today, I'm going to teach you how to review and QA a Mogurt. QA means quality assurance. With proper QA, we can ensure intuitive controls, optimize for performance, and provide a great user experience. Mogurts are built and authored in After Effects, but they're intended to be used in Premiere. We want anyone using our Mogurts to have a great experience. So it is essential to QA our Mogurts in Premiere, stress test the Mogurt ourselves, and fix everything before selling it, uploading it to a stock site, or giving it to our client. So how is it done? First, import that Mogurt to Premiere. I'm in the Graphics workspace, which has the Essential Graphics Panel, or EGP, open. Open the Browse tab, and then simply drag the Mogurt file onto the EGP, and it will import to the correct directory. Now, drag the Mogurt from the EGP onto your timeline. Once your Mogurt appears in the timeline, we move on to checking for reasonable playback. You should aim for perfect, or mostly smooth, playback after 2 to 3 playthroughs of the Mogurt. Everyone's computer and hardware is unique, but someone who's working on a standard MacBook or Windows laptop should be able to at least preview your work. You may be thinking that good Mogurt performance isn't necessary, or that your Mogurt is so cool and so powerful that it makes up for how slow it is. But I'll caution you. If a user changes a control and the Mogurt doesn't update because it's slow, the user will think it's broken. As an editor, the most frustrating experience is waiting for the computer to play back what you're working on. Mogurts are heavy, but if it's taking time to change the Mogurt controls and then wait for your changes to render to see what the changes did, your editor is going to be banging their head against the wall. Mogurts are building blocks. They're often layered with other footage in the timeline and need to play back smoothly with all the other footage to get a sense of what's going on in the edit. Sure, the editor can hit render and wait for the work area each time they want to preview the Mogurt. That's acceptable in After Effects, but that's not how people work in Premiere. Editing is supposed to be fast, and Mogurts are supposed to speed up workflows, not slow them down. That's why checking for reasonable playback is essential. So back to playback. Hit Control-Shift-F11. Then hit play, and you'll see a live update of data, like the dropped frames in your Mogurt. This hidden overlay in Premiere is called dog ears, and it'll help guide our performance review. As we play the Mogurt, we can see our total and dropped frames. Play it back a few times, and if you're seeing 50% or more dropped frames, consider going back to After Effects to optimize your Mogurt further. Optimization is a whole art in itself. The basic idea is that the more stuff you pack into your After Effects project file, the slower your Mogurt will be. In After Effects, there's a neat tool called the Composition Profiler, and it allows you to see how slow each effect, layer, or comp is. If your playback is unbearably slow, you're probably using too many effects, expressions, or layers. There's many ways to minimize and optimize a project in After Effects, and I'll make videos specifically on optimization in the future. Once reviewing for performance is complete, we can move on to stress testing all controls. To turn dog ears back off, hit Control-Shift-F11 again. Sometimes I need to reset the Mogurt when I'm reviewing. There's an easy way to do this. There's no way to reset the Mogurt in the EGP, but you can in the ECP, the Effect Controls panel. I'll pop that open and hover over this arrow. It says Graphic Parameters, Reset Effect. Clicking this will reset all of your Mogurt controls for the selected clip. You can also go to Graphics, Reset All Parameters. To make this process easier, I map this to a keyboard shortcut, Alt-R. Now I can just highlight a clip in the timeline and hit Alt-R to reset the Mogurt to its default. Now the fun part begins. We're going to check every single control and test for bugs or broken controls. Unexpected, unintuitive, or jarring results when editing controls. Check that every control is scaling, rotating, or moving from the intended points. Some controls need to be clamped, and they can have ridiculous minimum-maximum values by default. These sliders range from -32,000 to 32,000, making them essentially unusable. So those should be clamped ranges instead. Replace all your text and check that it is reflowing correctly. Check that your text alignment and justification make sense. Changing the source text, the font, or the text size shouldn't mean a user has to then reposition that text layer or resize its text box or background. Do those things automatically and add padding or offset options if needed. The next two control groups in this Mogurt contain color controls for the characters and the background. We'll change each of the color controls to test that they all work. It's okay if it looks garish while we're testing these. The important part is that they're all updating. There's multiple characters and styles in this Mogurt, so we'll be sure to check that the colors are updating correctly across all the possible variations. While you're testing all of these controls, you should periodically play it through again and scrub to different sections of your Mogurt to make sure the entire timecode is working. Sometimes the frame you're on is fine, but a keyframe or effect at a different point in time is causing problems. You won't notice this if you only review on a single frame of the Mogurt. Make sure to also check your Mogurt over the transparency grid. The program monitor in Premiere has a black background, so if your Mogurt has strokes, drop shadows, or transparent areas, you may not see those by default. You can get a transparent background by hitting the wrench icon and toggling this transparency grid option. I like to map this to the keyboard shortcut Alt-T. Now, when the program monitor is selected, I can hit Alt-T to quickly toggle the transparency grid on or off. When you're using masks or mats, make sure that your layers aren't getting cut off. Descenders in text are common culprits for this issue. For example, in this Mogurt, the G and Y are getting cut off by the mat. We can build this same Mogurt so our editors never run into this issue by writing simple expressions in After Effects. And finally, technically correct is not always visually correct. In this example, I've got a line hitting the corner of this text box, but it's showing this gap because the line doesn't extend into the text box. So we're technically hitting the right point, this corner, but visually it's not working. So I'd go back in and figure out how to move that line so it extends further into that text box and always looks right. You've reached the end. We ensured that the Mogurt loads in the Premiere timeline, checked for reasonable playback, and stress tested all controls. While you're QAing your Mogurts, look out for these gotchas by using the techniques you've learned today. If you're freelance or working for a studio, or if you're delivering your Mogurts to a stock site, they may have additional requirements. But by following all the tips in this video, you'll be creating professional-level Mogurts in no time. Thanks for watching, and catch you in the next one.